here 3 months ago, you're basically with a little bit of a roster overhaul. How is it that you have found your way back to the NBA Finals?
I think having a resilient group. We got a crazy group, but they're resilient, they're tough-minded, they know what it takes. Add the new guys here, they really understand what it takes to win now. And I'm just happy for the guys who are experiencing this right now. But first, I want to just give a shout-out to Kansas City, Missouri. You know that. Mexico, Missouri. Columbia, Missouri. All my people back home. And I want to give a shout-out to my coaching staff. Damon Jones, Larry Drew, Jim Boylan, Mike Longobardi, James Posey, Phil Handy, Vitaly Podopinko. And these guys, every single night, would come in and try to work on ways to win games. And they've been unbelievable for me. They've carried me. And I love these guys. And we're going back to V-Coy Hoyer for 4 straight years.
One about LeBron, because at the end of the ball game, Jeff and Mark said might be LeBron's greatest achievement, because given the different circumstances, no Kevin Love, how would you describe what he gave you in this series to get you here?
I mean, just LeBron being the best player in the world, you know, and this whole year he's led by example. You know, we've had a lot of guys in and out. We had 3 or 4 different new rosters. He played all 82 games in his 15th season to lead by example. And to show, you know, who he is as a person, his character more importantly, and, you know, play 48 minutes tonight to bring us home. And he's unbelievable, man. He's the best player in the world. I'm glad he's on my side. And going to a game 7, you want the best player in the world on your side.
Congratulations. LeBron, it's a little tired. He's just saying, do you have to talk again? So, LeBron, we talked a little bit about this out there, but tonight, describe the effort from the men behind you, because as great as you have been, it required some help. So, in different moments of this series, what do you remember about what these guys have given you?
I think what people don't understand, people that never played the game of basketball or never played team sports, is that in order to succeed, it has to be a team effort. You know I get a lot of the headlines, win, lose, or draw, whatever the case may be, but in order to be successful, it's a team game. I learned that from when I first picked up a basketball to play organized basketball at age 9. So you get all the doubters and people who've never stepped in an arena, who's never played basketball, who's never put on a tank top and shorts, who've never played anything organized, always want to try to kill my teammates. And it's unfair to them, but I'm always stay true to the game of basketball, because the game of basketball always stay true to me. And that's why we're going to another final, because my teammates played the hell of a game.
LeBron, to a certain extent, it feels like every time you step between the lines, there's a certain referendum on your career, and yet you keep going on and on. You know, what's inspiring you, even though you face obstacles, and you'll face another one in the finals, regardless of who comes out?
Listen, at the end of the day, the man above has given me a guide, given ability, and I just try to take full advantage of it. Win, lose, or draw, no matter what, at the end of my career, you'll never get someone to say that he didn't leave it all on the floor. You know, wins and losses and ties and things that happens throughout the course of life. It's just how you pick yourself up. It's how you continue to get better and better. And the difference between me and a lot of other people, or a lot of people who play the game of basketball, they get so in-depth and so deep about, you know, putting everything in the game of basketball. I'm true to who I am. I'm true to my family. I'm true to my teammates. I'm true to my craft. And then at the end of the day, whatever happens, happens. So, you know, I could care less about a finals record. I could care less if I don't, you know, play well at this game, or, you know, if my teammates don't show up, because I know how much I put into the game, and nobody can ever take that away from me.
Congratulations to the 2018 Eastern Conference champion, Cleveland Cavaliers. It's 8 straight from LeBron. Back to Scott Van Pelt.
George, thank you. J.R. Smith's got the trophy.